Hello. Just a big week. Thanksgiving. If you guys are like me, even though, I have Thanksgiving at my house every year because I can't make it to anybody's house. Nobody lives close to me. I finally gave up and, gave up on all that because that stressed me out and it stressed everybody else out and nobody argued with me. So that's how I knew I made the right choice because nobody, not even my dad, argued with me. And if that's the case, then you made the right choice. So everybody knows that, and everybody's got a choice of having it at their house. I'm not gonna get mad. So this year, my dad chose to have it at his house, because my stepbrothers, well, except for one, live down by my dad. My brothers, I'm just calling them all my brothers. They live closer to dad than to me, so. And then they have in-laws, so I'm way out of the way. So if people can make it up here anytime, I'm thrilled. My daughter lives like 180 miles away, and she's coming down. I just ask that I don't, that I'm not alone on Thanksgiving. I just ask that somebody comes so I'm not alone. I admit it. I don't want to be alone because I have a tendency, I have that seasonal depression, and the holidays are really hard on most of us, I think. Especially these stupid commercials, they stress me out, and I don't know why, but the Black Friday commercials and everything, they stress me out. Because I get all my Christmas shopping done online with what little money I have. And then the dollar store, and I usually get it done by Thanksgiving, not Thanksgiving, Halloween. Because I try to cut down on the stress. But anyhow, back to Thanksgiving at my house. Everybody brings something. When people are gonna be here, but they all bring something. And this year, my daughter wanted ham, so, and ham was on sale, so I hurried and got it. But the most stressful part is I gotta go to the grocery store and get salad. Because I couldn't pick up salad a week away from Thanksgiving. If they had more money, I'd ask them to pick it up. Anyways, I don't want them to send them to the store on Thanksgiving because I don't want to go to the store. Anyways, don't and can't are two different things. A lot of times, my biggest thing with the grocery store is I don't want to go. There are times when I can't go, but I never want to go to the grocery store. I'm not even gonna lie. I don't know who else is going to be here, if anybody else is going to be here, which I'm fine as long as somebody comes, I'm fine. And I try to invite anybody who I think might be alone to come because it's just holidays can really be hard. And then I finally, MP3 players are pretty cheap right now. The one I got, you can get for $19.99 at Walmart. You can do it online, and then you can just pick it up when it comes in the store or pay for shipping. Because I had a 5-disc CD player that a friend of mine had given me that she had like in storage or something, and then there was a brownout or whatever, a power surge here, and it blew it up. So I haven't been able to listen to. I listen to these guided imagery CDs that would really help between these CDs and then the light that a friend of mine gave to me, one of those lights. I had it in one of my videos that's like natural sunlight, and I just put it next to my bed and I read and have it on. Well, you can't keep it on for too long though, because that sucker will get hot. But let me show you, I loaded all of these on, and I still got tons of room, and some of these CDs are like 39 minutes long. So I do the Health Journeys, and I can't say her name right. Belle Ruth Napperstuck. Anyways, there's that fibromyalgia and chronic fatigue, helpful sleep, relieve headaches. This one you play when you aren't having a headache too, and it helps before you get a headache again. Ease pain. So that's just hers. Mind you, I got, I can never get the camera, so it's totally sturdy. Alright, then I have Christopher Love CDs, and this one's Forgiveness. And his are the longer ones. Pain management and pain control. The Wisdom Keeper. Oh, I swear this is the one that really I relax really a lot to. Psychic Learning and Healing Empowerment. I swear to you, I... OM Sound Healing. I didn't load this one on. Stop the Craving for Sugar. Then I have other ones that don't work as well for me, like Rain Dance and stuff like that. These guided imagery ones work the best for me. I quit having the post-traumatic stress nightmares. And they just help me all the way around to deal with a lot of stuff. If I'm feeling, you know, all this stuff from the holidays, then I play these. No matter how good I get at this at stuff, and for some reason I still just really don't. I really dread Christmas, and then when Christmas comes, I'm fine, and I end up having a nice day with my kids, but still I just dread it until it gets here, and then it's like, you know. So you can always vent to me, say whatever you want, you know, send me a private message and go off, I don't care, just as long as you're not going off of me, go off on how much you hate the holidays or whatever. I actually love Thanksgiving. And I don't feel too stressed about it, even though my kitchen is always a mess, because everyone helps me, whoever comes. And ham, you can't get much easier than that. Although last year we did have a turkey event. Sorry, Dad and Jackie. That's my dad and my stepmom. Why don't I just call her Mom? I don't know. I don't know. I've always called her Jackie. But, I forgot to turn the oven up, so the oven was set really low, and so it took the turkey forever, so we had to take it out and carve off the pieces, the parts that were cooked, because everybody was starving. My bad. But we just roll with the punches. That's the way my family is. It's not stressful. I don't have a big kitchen area, as you guys have all seen, but we make it work. None of us has a big kitchen area in my family. We all have about the same kind of deal. But we love each other and we make it work. I do love my family. I do. I have a really good family and we're really close and we harass each other and can talk to each other about stuff. Sometimes we make each other mad, and but it always passes, you know. I can always say the wrong thing or annoy someone, but most of the family, I think, just accepts that my brain doesn't work right with my illness sometimes, but every once in a while, I will annoy someone. Ooh, my throat's tickling. That's not good. Yeah, so don't stress, and try to be around people that you get along with. You got to think about you, because if you're making yourself go to things that are stressing you out where you don't get along with people, It's only going to make you sick and make you hate the holidays worse. So you need to think about yourself and do what works for you. My family could get mad at me thinking that's rude. She always has it at her house. She can't be bothered. I can't make it down to anybody's house. Everybody knows this. And they all accept it. But I'm lucky. I've got a good family, like I said. All right, I'm going to let you go. Hopefully this was helpful in some way, shape, or form. And I will talk to you all later. Happy Thanksgiving.